hands, Jesus. It was like the longest week thus far. Anywho, before I can get into anything, you know what time it is? It's a Friday, baby. Oh, God. Anyway, let's delve into what's happening in the world of celebrity and, of course, find out what's happening, what's not happening, and why are all these celebrities quiet? Look at this individual. Anywho, let's delve into celebrity gossip. According to the Kampala Sun, they're talking about Gashumba Mbuga. Franka Gashumba Senior is having a parenting nightmare. And I would like to ask, when hasn't Frank been having a parenting nightmare? Like when? He failed with the first kids. He tried to, you know, tried to really hold Sheila that in and still ended up beating her black and blue at the age of 20-something. I think. In Frank's world, this is not news. This is definitely not news. Anyway, they're saying, Frank Gashumba whips as trophy daughter Sheila elopes with boyfriend God's plan. And everybody's talking about God's plan. God's plan, God's plan. I even had to send in a few scouts. I'm like, well, no. Mumburi daka, umusa jafana natia, I know musa igwa bululu, ainachi. You know, we have seen abaganga banje Kampala, tubalabine. Nowadays, tuchaba ita abaganga, abafene tulabie banje, kuwa sente siza mwe, temuru wanazo, ngini gundi aliwa. Nasa. Nasa Mamula Banga is trying to show off at Pearl of Africa Hotel, but everyone around him was looking at him like, tuchimanyi chakulide, chakulide. They were even going slow on your money. God's plan. Why is this such a big deal? Apparently he has money. He's not into throwing the money, but when he's out, he makes sure everybody around him have a good time. I think he's one of those few ones who tayagade nyo butala, butala butia. Anyway, he's up in Dubai, gallivanting with Sheila. They're having a blast. Daddy Dearest thinks she has eloped. But here's the trick, though. This is why I don't get it. Frank, why would you call this a nightmare? Omwana gwe yamukuba emigo. The very night wamukuba emigo, natuterayo bifananyi ku Instagram ne social media platforms. In 3 days tops, she was running into the arms of God's plan. She has been living in a hotel for like about, I think it's coming to 2 months. Her mother checks on her at that very hotel every day. What are you telling me that this is a nightmare? I don't know why we cannot open up our minds to see syndicates when they are coming our way. I'm just saying. You know where she was at. This is no nightmare. You know she can take a flight and leave. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. Anyway, this God's plan guy. So I was trying to dig up all the trash and all the dirt that I can. Now, he happens to be a UK cat. Now, when you mention the word UK, my yard is. So I hollered my yard is. And I'm like, yo, help me find out something about this guy. They're like, which guy? Because we didn't have an image. We got the image. They sent me the deets. And I can't wait to share them. But not today. All I know is, Sheila, Genda Mpola. Yeah. Sentences tera kulasting along, especially Zizija. In a collective, Genda and Paula, because reports I'm finding out, I'm hearing from the UK, it's not dope stuff, but I can't say it now, because I risk being, sued for defamation? But why would someone sue me for defamation if it's not even their real name? Because he's calling himself God's plan. But his real name, I have found out, is Ali Ssemboga. Now, according to the Kampala Sun, they even tried to call him Marcus. No, he's not Marcus, he's called Ali Ssemboga. Like, Kampala Sun, you should have asked me. Just saying, namwe kamba kubi them. All I know, his sources of income are not specified, but I just want you to know that God's plan is not really a God's plan. It is more of amagezi yakoze samanjo kutuka kuplani ya mukame yojayo gerako. Just say it! Guys, I'm just going to throw random names, and then you'll tell me. Actually, we're going to play a game of spot the connection, right? Okay. Tandika, Gaimbenzen, what is the first name? SK Mbuga. Don Nasa. Ali Ssemboga. Shanita Namuimba, aka Bad Black. Zari Nantale. Mo who? Medi Mo. Medi Sentongo. Katsa the Punk. He's Muslim too, right? Right? And Ani? Medi Kingi Domuya, Nia Toyo, Naya. But now, just let us mutura around Gaza around in a circle and then spot the similarity. I'm just saying, because it seems to be in a certain state or race guarantees your levels of success. I mean, look at all the people I just mentioned. Can't we say they were successful for a minute? I mean, Bob Black is still a sensation up to today. Medicine to go well or your yeah, bullet is mukubalurwe. Don Nasa. Is your success story? SK Mbuga. In that field, akale mufieldi yabwe. Munajimanya. Mufieldi yabwe. Abane chintu bache kuwasaganyiza. I'm just saying, what do I need doctor shahada? Nina kotola bidyo kuongerako muzata. Oh no, muzata mbugwe toli ku list na yembu tubadde tukuinvitinga. Otule neno list. O babulirireko. Ne babulirireki. Because the last time I saw him around these similarities, mama, you're working very hard. Omwana mulunji. Abana bayine banange, I've not seen a grown man. I have not seen a grown man stoop so low. Stoop so low for paper. Jesus. Anyway, what am I to know? I am just a simple, useless gossip girl. You people, let me tell you. I know all of us want to be entrepreneurs. I know all of us have business dreams. And I know for a fact, tewali achasinze muyimbi kwagala kubera nezi business. Ye engato za palaso achazitunda. Sija yaina akaduka ke engato awe ntinda. Sima ikali kagwa wale wa yali akaba engato wega ya tugule engato. Anyway, that is besides the point. So I know most of you heard the rumor that, Jose Chameleon has a new bar. It's called DNA. It's his bar, blah, blah, blah. I was like, yo, I didn't even run the story. I was like, okay. I see you, Daddy Abba. I see you. Until sources on the inside came out and they're like, yo, Tina, dig this. Apparently, Mbuntino, apparently the bar is not owned by Chameleon. Mbu, they are doing like that kind of thing that, you remember when Swan's Avenue had just opened and we all thought Benon is the one that owned it because we didn't know Julius Chazze at the moment. They wanted a face that people could resonate with. That's the same thing they did for DNA, the bar. Now, all things were going according to plan, not entirely because the bar hasn't really got that much hype. People have not really gone there. Anyway, as all of that was going down, one of my sources hits me up and they're like, Tina, so check this out. There is a bar in the States, and it also goes by the same name as this bar. It's also called DNA. Now, I'm not so sure, because he was like, I don't know if they use the same trademark and all of that, but what coming in is they are suing the DNA of Kampala, Uganda, to smithereens, to nothingness. Reason, DNA in America had a trademark. It had a trademark, it had trademarked its situation. Kati, nembuza. Katibambi Chameleon anakula atya. Nagamba Chameleon mumuleke. Abazungu abali behind the real bar. Bagenda chisotinga. But then I asked myself, if this were abazungu, enaku zinoba na esimanya, abazungu benaku zinoba, they are slow. Oba they have been chilling with way too many Nigerians. I don't get it. This abazungu, you've seen something in the States. Then you come and do it here. You understand states' laws. You understand that trademark is going to be a problem. And you still come and do it here. What? You thought Uganda is so far off the block? So far, like it's so far off our map or radar of anyone important, they would not know there's a bar like that here. Have you met Joseph Mayanja? He's bound to make a lot of noise. So anyway, they're coming for the bar. They're coming for everything he owns. They want their name back. And then it hit me. I remember there was actually another saga like that when CBS America wanted to shut down the CBS Uganda because they were like, yo, trademarks, until they had to explain themselves. Now, as all of that is going on, I'm like, but wait, this bazungu cannot be that dumb. There's something bigger going on. And usually whenever I can't understand dealings like this, you know the first thing that goes into my mind? Somebody's washing something. Somebody's washing legal tender somewhere. If you don't understand that drift, I'm sorry. I can't explain it any further. But Katubali did it. I was so psyched. I thought, I was not really psyched. Okay, now this one is coming from a place of love. For the past couple of months and years of me doing Scoop and Scoop, I've had people reach out to me and they're like, oh yeah, Tina, I'm from Barara, I'm from Arua, I'm from Kabale, I'm from Mbale, I'm from all those beautiful towns that are outside Kampala. Do you know anything about artists here? And I get it. It just hit me that all these different towns have their own celebrity vibe. They have their own celebrities. They have their own scandals. So I took the time, sat down with the team, and we decided, you know what, let's broaden and make our horizon a little bit wider, you know, and bigger. So I'm calling out to anyone out there, if you're in Mbale, Arua, Gulu, any of the towns that are outside Kampala, and you know something about any of your stars, and if it is gossip, if it is scandal, whatever it is, and you feel someone should say on it or speak on it, it's quite simple. These are the platforms to use. Yes, Mumpere Zorugambo no wo abe yuga abe Kampala mbakoye. We cannot keep talking about Chameleon, Shiba, Nebani. There's interesting drama that happens outside, like in Mbarara. Yo, the celebrity drama in Mbarara. People sleep with each other in Mbarara in the celebrity scene. Whoa! It's quite simple. Like the way you've done in the past, you've reached out to me on Facebook, you've reached out to me on Twitter, and on Instagram, it's simple now, it's much more simpler. Go to any one of our platforms, even if it is Urban TV platform on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram or YouTube, wherever, simple. At Tina Fierce 1 is the Twitter handle. Tina Fierce 1 is the Facebook page. Scoop and Scoop is also our Facebook page. We have two communities, they're all merged together, they're vibrant. You know, you can choose either one of those. And on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce 1. But the Tina has an H. Yes, that's simple. This is 2019, you know. Other than that, it's been a rather dull Friday. I've had so much juice and information that I cannot divulge because I have to first sit with my legal team. But Monday is going to be lit. For now, though, don't drink and drive. Always wear protection if necessary. And what else do I usually tell them? Nothing. I'm out. Peace.